right, guys, welcome to part two on the custom Banshee with the 600cc sport bike engine in it. As you guys know, last video we got this thing running, actually, surprisingly. We went through the spark plugs, took all the spark plugs out, and we found that every single spark plug had spark, which was awesome. And then we actually filled up the carburetor with some gas and attempted to start it. Fired right up, like, instantly. So that was awesome. Today we're gonna get the tank cleaned out. We've got the Suzuki tank right here. We looked in here last video. It was a little rusty. I'll show you guys here. Just a tad rusty here. You can see in there, there's some rust chunks. I mean, it's not that bad, but it's definitely needs to be cleaned out. Then we can just put a fuel filter on it and call it a day. But we're gonna test it out first, get the fuel filter all hooked up, and see if we can get this thing to idle and run perfectly with the gas hooked up to it. I know last video it was kind of going on and off, I think because it was running out of gas. But we'll have to see. I wanted to check too if the battery worked. Let's just check and see if the battery works here. No, the battery's junk on it, so it definitely needs a new battery too. So once we get the gas tank cleaned out, we're gonna go to the carburetors and probably clean those out if they have to be cleaned out. I think we can just take all these off. Doesn't look like too bad of a job. We'll probably just clean out the bottoms of them, not worry about the top. These have diaphragms in them, so we can check the diaphragms, but other than that, I think we should be fine. Shake this a little bit up. That out now. All right, the tank is somewhat cleaned out. It's not perfect. It's never going to be perfect once there's rust in it. I mean, you can let it sit for a week with vinegar in it, and that only does so much. So let's just put a filter on it, call it a day. Let's see if we can get a filter on here. I don't know if this gas tank needs air pushing it through the other side, or if it will just be gravity fed. I don't know what the previous owner did. Let's see if that'll fit over that. Perfecto. All right, that's done. Let's get some gas flowing through it, and we'll try starting her up again. What would be great is if it just worked and we didn't have to clean out the carburetors, because I'm really not looking forward to cleaning four carburetors. All right, unfortunately, I'm out of gas. Let's go run to the gas station, grab some new, fresh gas, see if this thing works. I just tested the gas tank. It looks like gas was coming out of this end over here, so we gotta switch that around. All right, so it looks like gas is coming out of both ends of this. So we've got the gas line coming out of this end down to the filter into the carburetor, and I've got another line that I believe is the pump, kind of like it pulses from the carburetor into the tank and pushes the gas out. That's what I'm kind of hoping. I think that is the correct one. And I've got this one just clamped off for right now, just to see if this thing works. But right now, when we put the gas on, Gas does flow through the filter. You can see the gas in here. So I don't know how well it's flowing through the filter, but it definitely does. So we'll see when we start it up what happens. Hopefully it sucks in some gas. Looks like only two cylinders are running. The two outer cylinders are running. So I think we should take off the carburetors and just go through them, or at least take off the boots and see if it starts up here. So we'll take off each individual pod filter and just see what happens. Alright, you could hear it running for a little bit, but I think we should probably clean out the carburetors just to play it safe. We're having the problem with the two middle ones. Obviously, I think they're not getting gas, so I'm guessing maybe the needle is stuck in the off position, so the needle's stuck up into that seat. These two seem to be running, these two cylinders, so I'm guessing they're getting gas from somewhere in the carburetor. So let's just take apart the two middle ones first. Let's see what's going on with those, since those are the ones not running. Do this one first. These have new hardware on it, so I'm guessing the guy rebuilt it when he put these on. It's really nice with the Allen bolts. We don't have to strip out the screws. So for some reason, we're not getting gas. We'll see what's going on in here. Man, those look really clean. Does the needle come down? Yeah, everything looks really good in there, actually. Wow, look how clean that is. It's crazy. So gas is coming in through here. Gas comes in through here and goes through all these lines. For some reason, it's not going through there. Let's squirt a little something in there. So what happens is it fills this one up and then it goes to the next one and then it fills those up over there, and as they fill up they go on to the next one. So I don't get why it's filling the two over here up and not the two middle ones. It doesn't really make sense unless this one's clogged. So this one really doesn't look bad at all. Take a look at the pilot in there, see what's going on in there. See if that's clogged or not. Got it unclogged. This is going on for the main jet. Running out 12.5 for the main. And then what's the pilot here? The pilot's a 32.5, which is clear. Main is clear. Take a look at the float. No water or anything in the float or gas. See what the needle looks like. Needle looks really good. Good. Nice and rubbery. Thought that was a hole at first. No holes, slides up and down easily. That looks really good. Spring is there. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. So that can go back on. The air compressor, blow that out. All right, I went through every single carburetor. This one had a block pilot right here on the outside, and then that one had a block pilot, and then that one had a clogged pilot as well. So this is the only one with the pilot that was open. So it should run a lot better with the pilot jets unclogged. Not really sure why only two were running. Maybe the spark plugs lost spark. I'm not really sure, but we'll reinstall this thing and see if it runs better. All right, I temporarily hooked up a gas line. Let's just see if it sounds a lot better now. Don't think our two middle cylinders are running, so let's check spark there again. All right, we lost spark at these two middle cylinders. Lead to this coil. This coil controls spark plug 2 and 3. You can see 3 and then 2 coming over here. And we've got no spark going to it. I'm gonna check the grounds, make sure those are good. I already disconnected this connection going to it. You can see there's a black and yellow, and then a orange and white. So I believe this one's ground. So we're gonna check that, make sure that's good to go, and hopefully that works. All right, so I'm thinking it's the coil. I've got the bad coil, or supposedly bad coil, off of it. We're gonna do an ohm reading test. So you guys watch that while I do the reading. ohms. So 1 ohm. So that's that one. Let's go over to the other good coil. See what that reads. We're gonna do the same reading, same test, I should say. See what that reads. So that one's 3. So I think the other one's just junk, the other coil. Well, that's a bummer. Looks like we have to order a new coil. It failed the ohm reading test, so at least there's a part number on here. We can order one of those up, but that really sucks. I don't know how that coil failed. One last test we're going to do is we're going to plug those wires from that coil into this coil and see if we have spark from that coil. That'll tell us if the coil's bad. All right, if we get spark now, we know that the coil is for sure bad. Let's turn this guy on, see what happens here. Hopefully we get some sort of reading. Yeah, see, we got good spark, so that coil's junk. All right, here's the new coil right here. And then here's the old one. Should be the exact same. Tilt it that way. Just doesn't have the boots on it, so we're gonna swap over the boots and install this bad boy. This is gonna go that way. All right, here we go. Let's see if we got some spark. Hopefully we do. Let's see here. Oh yeah, baby. Good spark. That's awesome. All right, it's been a couple days since we last worked on this, but we got a couple grips in the mail. Again, Scott grips. I think these were like $11 this time. All right, one grip on, one more to go. All right, grips are on, looking pretty decent. All right, let's move on and see if we can get these lights to work. So what's a Banshee without lights? So we've got a couple wires coming out of the headlight right here, a green, a yellow, and a black. So it looks like this was the original headlight, right here, black, white, and yellow. Let's get the voltmeter here. Let's stick a couple in here and see what happens when we turn on the light. I'm guessing one is high and low, but I don't know if you guys can see the voltmeter. All right, you guys can. Let's see what happens when we turn on the light here. Oh yeah, baby. You can see it goes to 12. So let's see what the white one is then. So that one is yellow, goes to 12. What does the white one go to? White one, is that ground as well? Let's see, white one, not really sure what the white one goes to. But the black and the yellow should line up with the black and the yellow here. Oh yeah. Cool. All right, well, let's hook the lights. That's fixed. All right, check this out. Wiring's all done. Got the wiring all sealed up. You can see some heat shrink. All brand new connections. Looking pretty good. All right, let's see what happens here. Thank you. All right, that sounds a lot better. Let's just check the pipes and see if they're hot. That one's hot. That one's hot. Yep, they're all hot. Every cylinder's running. So that's awesome. The gas tank's not working out too well. We gotta get this thing pumping manually. It's really not working. I think this tank is supposed to have a fuel pump, and it doesn't have one, so we'll have to come up with something here. All right, fill up the gas tank pretty much all the way, so hopefully it goes now. This thing sounds insane. Oh my god. This thing is going to fly. You guys hear that thing? Holy cow. I'm really scared to ride this thing. Oh my. That is just insane. Oh man, that revs up so high too. Oh god. I don't know if I can ride this thing. We need to bring in somebody else to ride this. Who wants to volunteer for this? It's basically like, you're going to die if you ride this thing. If the throttle sticks, imagine. I mean, you can pull in the clutch, but what if the clutch doesn't work? You're basically dead at that instant. Oh, this thing sounds so fast. Well, it's definitely running a lot better. We gotta get the plastics figured out here. Maybe try to get something bolted up, and then we can take this thing for a test drive. So it looks like the gas tank's working now. I filled it up pretty far with gas, so it's about halfway filled up and it seems to be working. So I think it just had to get over that filter in there. All right, so I got the tank zip tied down somewhat. Doesn't really move. And then the seat, what the seat does, there's a little latch right there. See that little latch right there? That goes underneath right here on the tank. See that? Goes underneath there, holds that down. The other lip holds that down. And then what I'm gonna do is put two bolts right here that'll hold the plastic down, and then probably drill into it and then tap a screw into this so then it holds it from the side. So, and then the seat kind of locks in. So we'll see if that works. Thank you. voila, done. See, it's pretty tight. And when you sit on it, it won't move. All right, I'm gonna try sitting on it now, see what happens. Pretty comfortable, actually. It's not too bad. Looks kind of weird, but I mean, that's what it's gonna look like. I'm not putting much more work into it. It's not bad. I do need something for underneath the plastic right here. You can see the pipe is right next to it. So we're gonna put some tin foil and tape that to it underneath here. All right, she's all painted up, looking pretty good. I painted the pipe with some high temp paint, and then you can see the little headers I painted black as well. Touched up the plastics, painted in black, so it's looking a little bit better. All the rust spots in the frame I painted black. Oh, and I also fixed the shifting mechanism over here. We were having some trouble with this. I bolted that down and fixed it. So you can kind of get a shoe underneath there now, if you have to. So that's kind of nice. And then everything's bolted up, good to go. Next video, we're gonna do the oil change and then take this thing for the first ride. Stay tuned for that. It's gonna be insane. I'm actually kind of scared to ride this thing, to be honest. It's a beast. You can hear it run, it's insane. So stay tuned for next video when I attempt to ride this thing. Should be pretty fun for you guys. Probably not for me. Anyway guys, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, until next time, we are out.